Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Sarachandra IAS Academy. As part of our analysis and discussion on economic survey, today we are going to discuss the sixth chapter. The sixth chapter is an important and very interesting topic. We can say that this is the extension of the some of the process reforms that has been mooted for the last 4 or 5 economic surveys. Process reforms, the chapter name is Process Reforms Enabling Decision Making Under Uncertainty. Enabling Decision Making Under Uncertainty. This calls for simplification of procedures and simplification of complex procedures in a time-bound manner. This topic, the core theme of this topic is not a new. It has been discussed vividly in the previous economic survey, that is 2015-16 or 16-17, like 2014 and 2015-16 economic survey, that is exit Padma Vyuha. India's business process is trapped in Padma Vyuha or Chakra Vyuha. I think exiting business is very difficult. That has been discussed in that economic survey 2015-16. So this can be a continuation of that exiting business discussion of the topic exiting business or Chakra Vyuha, and also making the need for making the entire process simple and more time bound manner. So this is a very interesting topic, and this is definitely a right time to discuss this chapter, because even the budget also talks about minimum government and maximum governance. This is one of the major pillars in the present budget 2021 and 2022. So this is a parallel topic to that minimum government and maximum governance. So this topic is explained with some real time illustrations and the progress made by India through in the last 4 to 5 years through reforms and its improvement in the business processes. However, at the outset of the topic there are some issues have been discussed in the very beginning, that is the over regulation and opacity in the process of a business, the opacity or over regulation. The over regulation is in the fields of study of time and procedures, the time taken and the number of procedures involved in a business process, in starting a business or exiting a business. Also, there is lot of opacity or lack of transparency in the administrative procedures from the emphasis of starting a business or ending a business. So these two problems have been highlighted at the beginning of the topic, and these two problems are explained or verified with some of the indices and its progress and in its India's ranking in the indices. Look, somehow it has taken indices of World Rule of Law Index released by World Justice Projects. So World Justice Project releases World Rule of Law Index every year. So this year in 2020, the India's ranking is 45 out of 128 countries in the category of due process is respected. Due process is respected. Due process is respected has been explained in this chapter, because the real issues in the process reforms or the economic reforms stems from the fact that there is undue delays and rent seeking, complex procedures and quality of regulation is very low. All these four factors are leading to low ranking in some of the indicators in categories like government regulations, administrative procedures, and also ending the business or regulating the effectiveness. However, after examining the all indices, like India has been making very good progress in when it comes to due process in respect, but lacks it rank is very low in government indices like government regulations and their enforcement of government regulations effectively. India's rank is only 104. Similarly, administrative procedures are opaque administrative procedures. India rank is 89. Relatively, so all these with all these indices and rankings, we can say that there are good laws to comply with, good regulations to comply with in India, but regulatory effectiveness is very poor in India. That is why these two problems are highlighted, over-regulation and opacity. So there are number of laws and regulations to comply with India. Complying with these regulations is good, comparatively good, but when it comes to their effectiveness of this regulation and their implementation of these regulations has been poor. So this can be explained that, for example, if you take that the same due process respected in the category of due process is respected in administrative procedures, India's rank was 72 out of 102 countries. It means it is almost bottom, 72 out of 102 countries in 2015. It gradually increased to 45 out of 128 countries in 2022. So with this, we can say that due process is thoroughly respected in India. It means there are number of laws are to be comply with, but their effectiveness of the regulations has been poor. This also substantiated by taking other ranks like World Bank releases regulatory quality index. World Bank releases regulatory quality index. In this also, India's ranking has been poor compared to its peers and other developed countries. Regulatory index, like I said earlier, we have good laws to comply with, but their effectiveness of the regulations has been poor. The same is highlighted, the same is confirmed through regulatory quality index released by World Bank. Similarly, this also can be substantiated with other indices like World Bank releases ease of doing business. You know, all India's as its rank has been improved from 130s to 60, 130s to 60s in 2019. However, even though it made huge strides in the ease of doing business, two indicators have been very poor in the ease of doing business. One indicator is the ease of starting a business, and the other is registering a property. Ease of starting business, India's ranking has been very poor. It is 136. Out of these two categories, out of these two indicators, other indicators like 7 to 8 indicators, India rank has been very progressive. But ease of starting a business and registering a property, India has been very poor. Its ranking is almost at the bottom. 136 rank in ease of registering property and 154 136 in starting the business and 154 in registering property. With this, all this, the survey also tried to explain with a real-time illustration through a survey conducted by the Quality Council of India. Quality Council of India conducted a survey to explain the process of reforms in these delays or the issues arising out of over-regulations and opacity. So the Quality Council of India identified that when a company thought of ending its business, on the day one, if companies thinks that it should end its business process, it will take almost 1570 days to completely struck off from the company register of companies to officially end its business, to officially come out of the Companies Act register of companies. It almost 170 days, which is almost 4.3 years, almost approximately 4.5 years, which is high time, which is a huge time. Even the survey tried to compare this with the some of the countries like Singapore, USA, UK. Singapore takes 12 to 24 months, UK it takes on less than 12 months. So, but however, in India it takes more than 4 years. It definitely a longer time to end complete officially and its business. If you take these 1570 days, out of these 1570 days, almost 1035 days takes only for clearance of income tax, GST, and also PF. All the PF procedures and income tax procedures and also the GST procedures, or to complete this almost 1035 days is almost more than 3 years only to get clearance from these three departments. So definitely there is a over regulation and opacity. There is a need for simplification of the complex procedures. But the survey tries to explain why there is a necessity to these many process through some of the examples given by the Nobel laureates. She is under the heading of inevitability of incomplete regulations arises from the fact that these facts have been explained by some of the Nobel laureates like Herbert Simon in his paper submitted to the Nobel committee. In this committee, he argues that inevitability of incomplete regulations arises from the fact that future is full of unknown unknowns. Future is full of uncertainty. He explained with the phrase called unknown unknowns. Yes, we face many unknowns which are unknown. So it seems that this future is full of uncertainty. That is why there is an inevitability for over regulations or complex procedures. Second thing, Oliver Hart also explained that difficulties involved in anticipating and specifying all obligations for all stakeholders in case of contingency. So this is also during the uncertainties and contingency times, it will be difficult to anticipate the responsibilities of various stakeholders precisely. Because of these two reasons, the third problem arises. Because of the reasons of unknown unknowns and difficulties to fix the responsibilities, we can say that the third problem, we cannot take extante decision making unambiguously. But what we can observe is outcomes exposed. Exposed outcomes we can observe, but extante decision making is unambiguous in the present context. The third problem is arise. Extante here means before starting a business or before an event occurring, before an event occurs, or before starting a business. What we can predict is exposed outcome. What we can do observe, what we can observe is the outcome occurred after an event, output of an event, output of an event. We can have the control only that output of an event. But extante responsibility is unambiguous. So because of these two responsibilities, because of these two issues mentioned by the Herbert Simon and Oliver Hart, the third problem arises. That is, that third problem is we can observe outcomes exposed, but not verify extant decision making unambiguously. So all these problems makes discretion unavoidable. This is the main issue identified in this chapter. Because of the discretion, because of this unknown unknowns, because of these difficulties in fixing the responsibilities in times of contingency, and what we have control only on exposed outcomes and not extant decision making unambiguously, so this makes discretion unavoidable. Because of this discretion, these opaqueness and opacity in decision making is happening. So this discretion is the major cause that has been identified for the over regulation and opacity in this chapter, process reforms enabling decision making. And this also tries to explain some of the problems because of this regulatory default difficulties, because of this complex procedures. The foremost problem is it leads to overtime. It leads to overtime in, as I told you, it is already almost, it takes to takes 1570 days. It leads to overtime, and discretion is not provided with not provided or exercised even when there is no care to do so. Discretion is not provided or carefully exercised. Sometimes it leads to the misutilization of the discretion of the power. There is a formula because of this discretion for the increasing of corruption. There is a say, when there is a discretion and monopoly, combination of discretion and monopoly, minus accountability, when there is a lack of accountability, and when there is full of discretion and monopoly, it leads to corruption. That is what it is similar to that only. The process reforms enabling decision making and uncertainty is difficult because of this over regulation, that is monopoly of the government, and more discretion. Again, this government enjoys the more discretion, but lack of accountability, it leads to the similar issues like corruption or delay in the procedures. Like also discretion is questioned when benefit of hindsight. What hindsight? Discretion is questioned after the occurrence of the event. Discretion is questioned after the occurrence of the event. So discretion is questioned with the benefit of hindsight. So government always tries to follow the precedents. Because of this discretion, government will not be in a position to take flexible decisions. It always tries to follow precedents. So discretion also inhibits the flexibility or innovation in the decision making. So that the survey identified these four problems because of this discretion. Discretion occurs because of this inevitability of incomplete regulations. Inevitability of the incomplete regulations leads to the discretion. Discretion leads to the four problems that has been identified the survey. And also survey tries to give some of the solving these solutions for the discretion. So what the solutions the survey talked about is, it is clear that there is no substitute for active supervision and discretion, but specifically extante regulations cannot be substitute for ex post supervision. So that tries to, the survey tries to balance regulation and supervision. So as a regulation, extante regulation and ex post supervision is the main problem. Now we have to balance this regulation and supervision. So what we can do is, we can fix the extante responsibility. How can we do this? How can you make this extante regulation and ex post supervision should be balanced to solve these problems of over regulation and opacity is to fix more accountability. What we can is to fix more accountability, that is, that only accountability can be made to alleviate these problems. These problems, and to balance extante regulation and ex post supervision. So we can fix the accountability, strengthening the extante accountability. So before an event occurs, before a decision is taken place, so that is extante. If you fix that accountability before decision making, it leads to the strengthening of extante accountability, so that when there is extante accountability, the problem of extante decision making is prevented. When there is extante accountability is fixed transparently, the problem of the inevitability of incomplete regulations, the third problem, that is extante decision making unambiguously is prevented. So the other thing is to, apart from accountability, is to bring in transparency in decision making. So this is to incorporate decision making in every stage of the public institutions. So this makes the market more efficient, this makes the economy more efficient, this makes the business process more efficient, this makes the starting of the business or registering properties more efficient, ending the business, exiting out of the chakra vyuha or padma vyuha is more ease with more efficient, or liquidation process will be more easier. So the starting business will be more easier, more investors will come here. Apart from that, these two extante accountability and extante transparency, the survey also talked about built-in resilient exponent resolution mechanism. So this is like supervision. How? Exposed resolution mechanism. Exposed resolution mechanism also should be put in place. This resolution mechanism should be to solve all these problems. All these problems of exit. So to reduce the complexity in the procedures, to reduce the time time taken to end the business. This requires put in place technology also. Put in place technology, fixing more accountability and fixing more resolution mechanism with more experts in the various fields in the business process, and make these contracts more flexible rather than rigid contracts. So all these rules will prevent the issue of inevitability of the belief of inevitability of incomplete regulations. These problems can be solved. And also, apart from these solutions, there is also need for administrative reforms and procedures, administrative process reforms. Apart from fixing the ex-ante accountability and transparency and ex-post resolution mechanism, strengthening ex-post resolution mechanism, also there is a need for administrative process reforms. So you should give the direction to administrative process reforms. So the above approach has several implications. The need for process simplicity extends to the institutional architecture as well. So the ultimate supervision is public scrutiny and public leadership. To reduce this opacity and over-regulation, if you put in place public scrutiny and public leadership, it can be solved. These two issues can be solved. The complexities can be reduced. But the public lacks the expertise and knowledge to do that, to scrutinize. If you see this, most of the audit mechanism in India is exposed. Even social audit mechanism, which has been introduced in various central sector schemes, and some of the states have also enacted social audit, all have this exposed responsibility. So this makes this exposed responsibility through public scrutiny is more ineffective. Of course, the public scrutiny through social audit mechanism is a way of increasing transparency and fixing responsibility. But what this survey highlighted is, rather than having this public scrutiny exposed, why can't we have some administrative process reforms in the form of minimum government and maximum governance? Minimum government and maximum governance. Reduce the procedures and process and complex reduce the complex procedures and process required to start a enterprise or start a business process or start a commercial activity. Bring in many reforms in this income tax or GST or PF. Put in place technology, use technology. This has been highlighted. You see the ENAM or government GEM portal. GEM portal is a all ministries can procure the goods required through GEM portal. All procurement of the government departments and ministries is done through GEM portal. It is like reducing the complex procedures and human discretion, increasing the accountability. So put in place this need for minimum government and maximum governance is explained through a real-time example of the success of GEM portal. Not only GEM portal, if ENAM also. ENAM is also like reducing the various procedures at APMC market. Because of these procedures, complex procedures and various other fees required to pay at these agriculture market yards, many people are not able to get their benefits. But ENAM is doing this, all these complex procedures are solved through direct selling of the farmer produce through online, electronic national agriculture market. This is also an example of need for minimum government and maximum governance. So as highlighted in the survey, if you bring about these reforms, like increasing the need for extended responsibility, extended accountability, extended transparency, and also strengthening ex-post resolution mechanism, combined with the administrative procedures, that this definitely there will be more certainty in the Indian business side, in the Indian economic sector, more certainty in the investments, more certainty in the starting a business or ending in a business. Definitely, it will lead to the growth of realizing India's potential GDP, that is 5 trillion by 24-25. At the present inflation levels, our potential GDP is 5 trillion by 24-25. To realize that goal of 5 trillion economy by 24 and 25, there is need for increasing the certainty in Indian economy. That can be done through the reform suggested in the economy. Thank you.